Chairman. I've learned over my career as a public servant that government is only as good as the people who run it, and we need leaders with the values and the courage to do what it takes to make government work for the people it's supposed to serve.
Carolyn Coleman is a wonderful leader. She has all the qualities that you want to see in a good person.
I've spent my life trying to be a leader that takes responsibility for my actions, working on behalf of people across this country.
You know, her activism didn't begin when she was 40, 50, 30, but even when she was a teenager in Georgia, she understood that she had a responsibility to use her gifts to open up doors and opportunities for other people.
And even those who are not from this country.
As a Hispanic that benefited from her leadership in bringing a voice and people to the table to make things better, she certainly believes that we all have a stake in the game.
There's so many people out there struggling to put food on the table and gas in their car tanks and keep their homes. I know sometimes it gets tough for them. I see that every day, and every single day it happens in every city.
Well, I've known Carolyn Coleman all of my almost 30 years of public service. And throughout that time, she's been a good personal friend. We talk about a lot of things. We talk often. We bounce ideas off of each other. She's very committed to the people that she works for. She's very committed to people that she believes in. You can depend on Carolyn Coleman. We exchange ideas a lot. We fuss a lot, as friends would do. But all in all, I know that if I need to call on her for something, that I can depend on her.
My relationship with Carolyn through NAACP, through a number of other organizations, she has been one of those persons who helped me see issues and understand issues that I would not have seen. She's been one of those persons who has experience, knowledge, as well as a great understanding of how public policy works, how funding sources work, and who the players are. And so she's guided me through that process, and as a result, I am a better public administrator. In addition, I've been a better advocate in my roles in the various community service organizations that I'm a member of.
We must remember that the Wilmington riots was a national issue 110 years ago. The NAACP nationally believes that it still is, and as a result, our National Board of Directors has passed a resolution in support of the work that we're doing.
Carolyn is probably the most sincere human rights person I've ever met. And, you know, it's just who she is. She doesn't know she's fighting when she's fighting. Because that's just who, you know, who Carolyn is. She doesn't know that she may step back and think she's not giving, or she needs to do more, when she's done more than anybody else at the table.
I had the pleasure of working for Carolyn from, I guess it was 1998 to 2000. I enjoyed working for Carolyn. She has a great personality, but I often would get on her case because I felt like she was just doing too much. But she would remind me that of what her role was, and she always said that she was here to help people. And so I said, I agree with that, Carolyn, but you gotta take care of yourself. And she would be like, I got this. So you have this, I got this, so.
The real thing you always knew with Carolyn was she never forgot where she came from. And when you were with her, you didn't have a fear. You didn't have to worry about knowing where you came from. You knew as long as you stayed true to your the values that she was going to be there with you.
Carolyn Coleman came into my administration in a position that was one of the very top ones in there in the governor's office with me.
And people would criticize because Carolyn in the administration went off and protested and got, I think, was arrested. But that was Carolyn's roots. And in fact, that was, and she would make sure that we all understood our roots, and we felt we knew we had a colleague.
And we didn't want to see Alma, and myself were very concerned about her putting herself out there. I was quite surprised when I was down on my knees praying. I was watching and praying, and looked over to see two sets of unfamiliar legs who were standing over us.
That was my first time really being arrested, truly being arrested. And I remember when they put the handcuff, we thought they weren't going to arrest us initially because they took all the ministers in first, and we were about to leave. We didn't think they were going to arrest us. And we looked at each other and said, well, I guess they're not going to bother us. And then they came over and said, you're under arrest. So we put our hands out and they put the handcuffs on. I was trying to get to my pager went off. It was on my belt, and I was trying to get to it, and that's when Ms. Coleman informed me that if I kept moving my hands around, the cuffs were going to get tighter. She said, the more you move them, Adams, the tighter they're going to get. And sure enough, she was right about that, so I got my lesson in handcuffs that day.
She did not talk to me about that, and she didn't need to talk to me about that. I expected Carolyn Coleman to do what she thought was right. I hired her because she had done all her life what she thought was right.
Carolyn has been very important to me, and really, in my opinion, helped to start my career. Knowing how important the NAACP and its mission is to Carolyn, I was not at all surprised to see her there. But what I was surprised was to see her there in the audience, risking her safety and her health, being right there in the thick of it. It was a very tense situation. As the crowd began to move a bit and sort of shuffle, jostle a little bit, Carolyn was there, sort of in the back of them there on her walker. She was there in a a picture of strength, just as everyone else was. The walker was, to her, I think, non-existent. And I sort of asked her, Carolyn, don't you want to move out of the way or move to a safer place? And she said, oh no, I'm standing right here, and they'll have to arrest me just like they arrest, everyone else.
Ms. Coleman is fearless. She's full of heart and love. She's somebody who understands that the way that we get to be America is to move closer to our ideals, to move the place that is America closer to the idea of America. And that's why I love Ms. Coleman. And Ms. Coleman inspires us to keep on fighting. She has the same heart, the same vigor that she had when she was a young organizer in the NAACP, now that she's an esteemed board member. We need more Ms. Coleman's. If we had more Ms. Coleman's, this country would get a whole lot better, a whole lot faster.
Carolyn, I'm sorry I'm not with you tonight, but I want to tell you, you are great. I have been so fortunate to be your friend, your colleague, so fortunate to have you at the highest level in my office as governor, and I'm so proud of all you're doing now in Guilford County. You keep up your good work. I talk about you all the time and the great things you've done and are doing. There's so much left to do. I'm so proud you're leading it, and I want you to know that your friend Jim Hunt is behind you all the way, proud of all you've done, and I want you to keep moving us forward with everything you've got.
Congratulations, Ms. Coleman. It's been a tremendous blessing to work with you and continue to work with you every day. And I do think When we look in this region and we look at all of the people that have made a difference in this country, the fact of the matter is Region 5, Mississippi, Alabama, South Carolina, Georgia, North Carolina, Tennessee, it has been from this region that the fight has always been engaged. It is from this region that the civil rights movement was birthed. It is from this region that we have the Rosa Parks, that we have birthed the Ella Bakers, and that we have a Carolyn Q. Coleman. And we thank God for not just your work you have done, but the continuing work that you continue to do and the way you continue to inspire us to always remember that we are called, no matter what the challenge, to have courage. God bless you.